Hi, I'm George Pearson, and this is training for CorelDRAW. These are just a few examples from some of my video tutorials. Let's just get this stuff out of the way here. Now, when you're working along with my project, you can download the actual project file. You'll find a link right there inside of the description. Let's go ahead and take a look at the description, and you'll find a link in there to download this file. And of course, make sure that you like the video. Share the video with your friends and also subscribe. Okay, let's go ahead now and get on to the video tutorial. In this CorelDRAW 18 or X8 version video, we're going to be making a quick basic logo here. The main thing I want to show you really is how to be using these different gradients. And it's really a video about using gradients. We'll just use the logo as kind of a place to put those gradients. Let me just dock this back down here. There we go. Which I'll put down here by the welcome screen. Okay, there's our basic look. Let's click on the new file button right there. Now I have this thing set at letter 8.5 by 11 and it's horizontal. I'm working in the CMYK mode here for printing. RGB of course is for monitor, CMYK is for printing. Resolution of 300 and choose OK. And there's our file. Now the first thing we want is to put in a background in here, and we need an object to work on. So to fill the whole background, go over here to the rectangle and just double click on that. And that places a rectangle filling your page. It's that easy. Just double click, fills the page. We now need some content in here, so let's just go to the right hand side and grab the drop down. Here's our cyan. Pretty good. Now I want to put a fill on this. Notice that I have my object properties open on the right hand side. I usually do that. If you're not seeing object properties, go up to Window, come down to your Dockers, and you'll find object properties right there at the very top of that list. Now I could do the fill right from here. Just click on that. Here's our basic fill. We want to have a fill like this. Elliptical fountain fill, and then we have our colors down below. Now, if you want to have more control over this, you want to use the interactive fill control, and that's at the bottom or down towards the bottom of the left side tools over here. Now it's not showing because my window on this video isn't tall enough to show that, but right down there a little double arrow, click on that, there's the rest of my tools. So there it is, that's the interactive fill tool. And so here is our interactive fill. Okay, now the middle part here, I want this one. Just double click on that. I want this to be that cyan color. So I'll go to the color selector here and right there, Pantone process and Pantone cyan. There we go. Close that down. The outside one, double click on that. Bring up this little control here and just to the left here we have blue, it's CMYK blue. There we go. Now I can take this control and I can pull this out and adjust how large that gradient is. And that's pretty good. There's kind of a nice, subtle, soft gradient. Notice that I also can control some of this stuff over here on the right-hand side in the fill section. Okay, we'll just set that. So there's our background. I now want to have kind of a swooshing thing in here, just giving us some background detail on this, but also using gradients. Let's go over here to our shapes and come down to the banner shapes right there. There's our banner shapes. Few options. I'm using just the default banner right there. And go right up here just on the left-hand side, click and drag, and pull that across to the right-hand side, kind of through the middle. There we go. So there's our basic banner effect. So that's our banner object. Notice on the right-hand side over here, there's no fill and so forth. So I'm going to do the same thing here. Let's just give this one a cyan fill right from our right-hand side. And let's give it a fountain fill just like that. Let's go back to the interactive fill. There we go. This time I'm going to pull the left-hand side, just kind of put it right at the top here. Grab the right-hand side, pull that down straight below, and let's change this I'll do it dark at the top, light at the bottom. So double click, and that will bring up your little mini controls here. And let's set this one at the cyan. There we go. Close that. Double click on the top, and let's set this one at the blue. And there it is, just kind of a little swish in there. Now I don't want to have any black line on that. That's the outline. So let's go up here to our object properties. Outlines at the very top, and let's set this at none. There we go. Okay, part one, part two done. There's our little background swish and the gradient in behind. Okay, now we need to have a big circle in the middle. So go to the circle tool, and then if we hold the control key down just like that, it gives us a perfect circle. And I'll make it a bit larger. And then I'm just going to use my arrow keys on the keyboard to kind of tap this into position. I want it as basically centered. And just using the cursor keys, the arrow keys on the keyboard to nudge that into the spot that I want. There we go. Okay, so far so good. Let's now fill this with white. Come over here to our white, click on that. There's our white fill. Let's change the outline here to 50. Hit the enter key. That gives us a nice thick outline on that. So far so good. Now I want to separate the outline from the fill so they're separate objects. You can do that up here at the object menu. Come down to convert outline to object. There's also a shortcut key for that, Control Shift Q if you do this a lot. We're going to convert the outline into a separate object, and there it is. There's a separate object. You can kind of see the little control handles on that, little mini handles. So here's the circle, and if I come outside, there's the outline. Okay, back to our circle. Let's now change the transparency on this. I'll use the transparency tool right over here or right up there on the object properties. Either way, we'll do it this way. Here's our controls. Set this at 90% transparency, which of course is 10% opacity. Maybe 85, just a little better here. Hit the enter key. There we are. It just gives a kind of a lightness in here. Let's now change this to a gradient just to have some fun with this thing. Again, a little bit of gradient. We're doing gradients throughout this whole video. Let's go to our gradient tool, and we have white to white. Let's go back to our interactive fill. Again, little double arrow, and there it is. There's the fill, white to white. Double click here, brings up our little controls, and I'm just going to pull this down bottom left hand corner. It gives me a pure black. So it's real subtle in there, just kind of a darkening on this right side. Very, very subtle effect. Okay, there is that. Now I want to have a white swoop up here, and we'll do that again with the ellipse tool. And I'll begin out here someplace, just kind of draw down like that, kind of making this big ellipse across the top. Notice how this kind of a curve right in there. So that's my basic ellipse. Let's give this thing a fill of white. There we are. Let's change the outline here to none. That looks good. Let's change the transparency on this thing. So back to our transparency. And this time I'll set this at 75. So it's not quite as transparent. You can see it right there. Now I want to have this just inside of this circle. Click outside, click it again so you can see that this is selected, this piece. Let's now put this inside. We'll do a power clip on this. So object, come down to power clip right here, place inside frame, and then click in the frame you want to go inside of, which is the circle, and there it is, it's inside of that circle. Now I can control this down here. I can edit the power clip. I can select the contents, extract contents, lock contents to power clip. Lots of fun little stuff down here. But we're done with that. So that's now just kind of inside of that circle. So far, so good. Let's now edit this. Click on it once. Brings back up your controls. Click on the edit power clip. So we can now get to the shape. The shape is inside. Let's put a gradient on this one inside of our power clip. Exact same trick as before. I'm just going to change this to a fill over here. And then let's bring up our interactive fill. There it is, we're going white to white. Let's change the right-hand side to a black, double click. Brings up our controls. Drag to the bottom left-hand corner, there it is black, so it's a white to black. I'm gonna pull the center bit over a bit so that there's more white and a shorter on the black. When you're done working with this shape, just come down here and close that out. So there's just kind of little subtle gradients happening in that real world subtle stuff. Just a little more interest in here on this. Okay, let's now do our fancy gradients on this outline. So click right on the outline and you should see all these little control handles. You know that's selected. Let's again change this to a gradient. There we go. And let's bring back up our interactive fills. Again, the little double arrow. And there's the interactive fill. There we are. I'm going to take this. I'm going to pull this around. There you go. Drag it up here to the top. Put just above. And let's drag this one down to just below. It's kind of snapping onto the edge. I don't want to quite do that, so just bring it just away from the edge a little bit. Let's make the bottom one black again, drag down there. So black and black. So now put one in the middle. I'm just going to double click. Notice we get the kind of a four-way arrow there. When you see that, double click, and it gives you a stop at that point. Let's put that right to the center. And let's change this to a dark gray. So here's our grays, that's our black. Got a dark gray right there. That's Pantone Cool Gray 10C, if I'm going to be real specific on that. Now come down about halfway between the center point and that one right here, double click. And let's make this one white. Just drag upper left hand corner, that's white, there we go. Same thing here, double click. And change this to a white. And there it is, kind of our fancy metallic-y look on that surround circle, again using those gradients. Let's now put in some text, some just simple text in here. We'll do some gradient fun on the simple text as well. Okay, back to our type tool. Here's a little text tool right there. Click inside someplace, that gives us our type. Now this is set at 24 point. I want something a little larger than that, actually quite a bit larger. Let's first set our typeface in here. I'm using Gill Sans Ultra Bold. Any big fat typeface is fine on this. We need to go much larger, and I'm using 235 points. There it is, just a big thing to type in HB. There it is. The reason I'm using HB, if you're curious, is that's just one of the hardnesses that I used a lot on pencils back when I was in art school. Only reason I chose that at all. So there's the HB effect on that. So we have our HB. Okay, let's now take a look at this. And we have our character right here. Transparency is right there. Paragraph we're not dealing with. Summary, we're not going to be doing anything with the summary on that. So you have those different options. Let's start off here with a magenta, kind of real bright magenta to begin this as our basic coloration. Now when you're on the text, right down here is your text outline. Let's change this to outline. You can choose a number like that. I want this actually to match the outline of that, and that was at 50. So I'll type in 50, hit the Enter key. There we are. There's that outline. Now that we have that, let's do the same trick on that we did on the circle. Let's detach the outline from the lettering and make it its own object. And once again, that's Object. Come down here to Convert Outline to Object, and there it is. So now if I click on the outline, there's my outline. Actually, there we go. There's the outline, and then there's the lettering inside. Okay, click on the outline. Let's put our gradient on this outline. Go up here to the fill. There we go. Here's our fill. Change this to a gradient right there. There's a fountain fill. And then back to our interactive fill right here. You can see there's that line again. We'll do the same thing here that we did on that outside circle. So I'll drag that, there it is, just above. Drag the bottom one just down below. It should snap to being perfectly vertical. And let's change the bottom color here to black. Again, just drag down to the bottom corner. There's our black, black to black. Look for that four-way arrow, double click. Give us a new spot in the middle. Let's make this one that slightly darker gray, which is right there. And then drag that to the center. It should snap to the center. Double click between those two, make this one white. Come down here, double click between those two, and let's make this one white as well. Then you can fine tune this by pulling those up and down. So there's that metallic effect on the outside. So all I have left to do here using all these different gradients is to do a gradient now for the inside of the letters. So same thing, we're on our lettering right here, as you can see there. We have uniform fill. This is our letter fill. This is fill for the line that the letter is sitting in. You don't want that. You want the uniform fill up here. Let's change this to a fountain fill, which is your gradient. And then back to the interactive fill again. There it is. Do the exact same trick. Just grab that, drag it up here. And let's drag this around down here. Double click on your top one. Let's bring that up, and here it is. I'm going to pull this down a ways like that and pull over here to the right-hand side. Right-hand side is full saturation, so I'm just making it dark, but still kind of a dark magenta. And choose OK. Let's come down to the bottom one, double click, bring this up. Now in this case, I want this to match that, so I'll grab my eyedropper. And so I can actually eyedrop right off of the image here, right off the lettering. There it is. I could have just copied the numbers if I wanted to, do it that way as well. But this is real fast and easy. Okay, that's the top and the bottom. Let's now put a centerpiece in, double click. That just matches that same coloration. Double click at the top. And let's change this one to a real bright magenta. See if we can find our exact magenta in here. There we go, 100% Pantone. That works. That's a good coloration. This is the CMYK version down there. I'll go for the brighter one. And then let's double click again down here. Eyedropper, and I'll steal it right from the middle of that. So there's our basic coloration on that. You can go darker if you want to on these ends to make it even stronger. Just kind of bring this down a bit. Double click down here. Let's bring this over and down a bit. And I'll darken down that middle one. To give us more contrast in there. Now let's just give this a bit of a slant. You can do the slant just by grabbing this top control. Pull it over here. Notice now how the whole thing slants as I do that. Grab the bottom one, pull the bottom one over, and then gives us that nice slant in here with that gradient following this slant. Click outside, and there we go. So real quick little logo, but using lots of gradients in all kinds of fancy different ways. So a nice little how to use gradients videos. There you go. It's how to make a fast logo, and also how to use the gradient tool, and of course how to separate out the outline, making it into its own object, and then add gradients onto that outline as well. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you found it useful. If you like this video, click on the like button below to let others know. You can click the subscribe button so you don't miss any of my videos in the future. I'm frequently uploading new training videos. Don't forget to check out my website at howtogurus.com. You can share this video with your friends and coworkers. Just click on share and then click on the social media buttons. Feel free to comment on my videos. I try to answer all comments as quickly as I can.